Why is it after the fact that you realized you knew that your intuition told you so? It's so annoying to feel like your intuition told you something and you ignored it. It could have been some important message. In this episode, I'll tell you why you ignore your intuition and how to fix it.
Welcome to Between Heaven and Earth, an internet radio talk show where we help you connect spirit and divine guidance. Lisa Kay, your host, brings you shows that can enhance and transform your life with tips and new ideas for more happiness, abundance, and better relationships. Lisa is an expert on intuition and can show you how to strengthen your inner guidance to empower yourself. Each show is positive and uplifting to inspire your day. Her guest speakers are specialists on self-help, positive thinking, spirituality, and conscious living. Be the best that you can be with Between Heaven and Earth, conscious living for your soul.
Now, Nikki worked for a real estate company as a receptionist. It was a steady job, not too challenging or hard to do. And she worked there because she wanted to become a realtor and sell homes. And she felt that this was the best way to do it. She was a receptionist, answered the phones. And one day, no one was in the office and she was all by herself. It was a bit of a boring job and Nikki was bored. She was really bored. And she thought to herself, I'm so bored. Suddenly, she had an urge, kind of a pop of a thought in her head, to look in the newspaper. Now, this was a long time ago, back when we didn't have the internet, but we had paper newspapers. And she was scanning through the newspaper, just flipping the pages, and a job advertisement caught her eye for a technology company. And she just called them up just for the heck of it and asked about the job. And it turned out that the office was just down the road and they set up an interview for her for the next day. Well, she went to that interview and by the end of the day, she had the job. And in 24 hours, her entire life changed. Because at that job is where she met her future husband, who she's been married to for 30 years. She also still became a realtor, even though she didn't work at a real estate company. So what do you think would have happened if she had ignored her intuition? If she didn't follow that urge, that pop of a thought to go read the newspaper just at that time? Perhaps the job would have been filled if she looked later, or maybe she would have never seen it at all because she never picked up that particular newspaper. You don't want to ignore your intuition because, gosh, it could be really important. It could be giving you a very, very important message. And we often go back and think about, oh, I knew that, or I had a feeling that was going to happen, or I knew that about that person, or I was going to go buy that magazine or go look at that book, but I don't have time to do that. Or why should I go read that magazine? That doesn't seem to be very relevant to what I'm doing today, or I've never looked at that kind of magazine before. But maybe your intuition's telling you something. It's giving you a message about something that you need to look at. And you may find that you miss your intuition message quite often. And there's a reason why. We're actually ignoring our intuition. And these are the reasons why you ignore it. So number one is intuition is actually very subtle. We expect it to come to us in a very clear, loud voice, probably because it's the same expectation of the way we hear our thoughts in our head. And intuition will come to you as some words or as a thought, but it often is very quick. It's fleeting and it's subtle. So intuition comes as feelings that are subtle. It could be a word or two or a short sentence or images, but they're very subtle. And this is why it's so important to practice using your intuition, practice doing intuition exercises so you can know exactly what intuition is like inside of you, because we're all obviously different, but not only that, we're what we experience is only we can know what that feels like, what it sounds like, and what it looks like. So when you practice and when you're working with your intuition consistently and consciously, you're going to start to recognize, oh, that was my intuition. I felt it, or I heard it, or I saw something in my mind. And it was quick. It was so fast. In fact, I remember there was one exercise, and you can do these exercises yourself as well. You want to be able to validate your the information that comes to you. And there was one time where I was going to visit a doctor who I had been seeing periodically. And I knew from the previous visit that he was complaining about his back bothering him. And so I thought, oh, gee, I wonder how he's doing. And I thought, oh, I know. I can just use this as an intuition exercise. I can tune into my intuition, use my technique, and see what I get. So I did. And I tuned in and I got a picture that popped in my head right away. I saw him standing on and in the doorway with crutches. He was wearing a white and green striped shirt, and he was hunched over in crutches. And immediately my mind thought, oh, don't think like that. That's a terrible thing to think. That's awful. And I pushed it out of my mind. And then I got some other information. You know, I focused on my intuition. I got some other information, and which turned out to be correct. But what happened was, a few minutes later, when he came into the examining room to see me, he was hunched over on crutches, wearing a white and green striped shirt. And I was shocked. I was so surprised. And I thought, oh my gosh, it's terrible. And I then realized, oh, wait a minute. I saw that. I saw that when I did my exercise, and I pushed it out of my mind. But it was such a quick flash. And then I dismissed it. I reasoned it away. So when I recognized that, I realized, oh, that's the experience. This is how an image can flash its intuition and what it's like, and that it's subtle and it's quick, and also that I tend to use my thinking mind to analyze it and to dismiss. And so I learned not to do that. I learned to look for those subtle flashes, whether it's an image or a word or feeling, because I started to recognize them through intuition exercises. And then they became more noticeable to me. So the next time I had a flash of an image in my mind, I noticed it. And that's what happened when I was driving one day. I was driving to the airport and in a rental car. It was a black SUV. And I was driving down the highway, and we were going around a large curve. And in my mind flashed an image. And the image was the car rolling over and ending up on its side. And it was in my mind, the picture was me looking down and seeing blood, and then it went away. And I thought, oh my gosh, that's not good. And so I slowed down because I had thought that maybe it was a message for me and how I was driving or where I was driving. So as we came around the turn and it was a straightaway, I could see way down on the highway going in the other direction, there was a traffic jam. And there was a long line of cars that had been stopped. And I was wondering, gosh, what happened over there? And as we got closer and closer, and I looked, of course, like everybody likes to rubberneck, right? I looked, and there was a car on its side, and it was white. And I remember that in my image that flashed in my head, was the car wasn't a black SUV, it was a white car. And I thought that was a little strange. And then we passed an accident where the car was on its side and it was white. So what in that case, the image that popped up was basically a premonition, if you will, or telling me that there was an accident down the road. And, you know, was it a warning? Yeah, I think it was in a way, because one of the things that you don't want, well, first of all, it wasn't about me, but it was about slowing down. It was about a lot of people in my side of the road were slowing down to look at the accident. But at the same time, you know, you don't want to be flying down the road and all of a sudden there are people stopped or slowed down to look at that accident. So it was like giving me a caution. So I was able to recognize it because, yeah, now I know what subtle is for me. So that's one thing. That's one of the reasons why we miss our intuition message or ignore it, because it's too subtle. It just goes right by us. The second thing is that you don't trust it. When you don't trust yourself and you don't trust your intuition, and a lot of people don't, I know I didn't in the beginning, it's very easy for your thinking mind to get in the way and talk you out of listening to it. You aren't sure. And when you're not sure, then it's easily dismissed. The third thing is that you give more weight to your thinking mind. We often give more value to our thinking instead of our intuition. And that's because our thinking mind is the one we work with every day, the one that's planning, the one that's helping us navigate and do executive thinking, as we call it. And the intuitive mind is softer and it's giving us information, but we're not always used to working with it. And our thinking mind and our intuitive mind are often at odds with each other, because the role of the thinking mind is to debate and to doubt and to judge. And we hear it more loudly because we work with it all the time. And the intuitive mind is just giving us information. It pops it out. And maybe we listen and maybe we don't. And when you don't listen, then you miss it. Okay, and number four is you're not used to listening to your intuition. If you're not used to listening to it or working with it and know what your intuition is like when it comes to you, it's so easy to miss it. So that's why it's really important to work with your intuition on a consistent basis, knowing that it's there, practicing using it, working with it, and practicing with other people is even better. So the solution to not ignoring your intuition is to do this, to keep working with it. And you have to develop that skill so you can recognize it when it pops up. If you'd like to know a little bit more about how to access your intuition to, say, use it to make decisions, you can go to my website at lmk88.com and get that free guide. I'm Lisa Kay, and you've been listening to Between Heaven and Earth, Conscious Living for Your Soul. Thanks for listening, everybody.